back to another episode of 7 Days to Alpha 18.4. Today we return, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. As y'all may or may not recall, we finally got a helicopter built in the last episode, so we've been having a little bit of fun with that. We were just on that rooftop and finished looting it up. However, we do have a quest right over here that I am very interested in exploring, so if we could just go ahead and kind of slowly descend our way downwards, because the gas is looking a little bit tight on this helicopter situation. I don't want to be using it too much over here. We got a little bit more questing to get done, but yes, we did do the massive milestone of finally building the gyrocopter, the helicopter vehicle of 7 days to die, where I have put some of the loot that we did acquire in just the last episode away. And, well, we got a mission over here that I definitely want to knock out, because we are in the midst of trying to really up the amount of experience that we have and acquire, because we are trying to further our advanced engineering perk over here, which is going to require us to get our intellect up to level 10, which is going to require quite the few points for us to do. But just last episode, we also finally learned the inventor perk, which is going to be huge, because as y'all can read over there where my mouse is, learn to craft shotgun turrets. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, our base defenses for the forthcoming day 28 horde. As y'all can see over at the top of the screen, it is currently day 23, but for the day 28 horde, we are going to be very, very prepared with some of those shotgun turrets. And how do I have to like parkour up to this thing, dude? Like, what in tarnation? This is quite an interesting way we got to make our way up here. Let's make sure that we have our lucky goggles on to make sure that all is looking lucky. Oh my god, noises! Hello, okay. I'm gonna start that nurse you back to health quest, which means I believe I should get swarmed by nurses, but oh my god. We also didn't get this baseball bat in the last episode. Swing, bada bada bada, swing, which is a pretty freaking dope, dude. We got a barbed wire, not the barbed wire, but like the chain mod on it, because you guys can see that there's like literally an entire like chain just wrapped around the baseball bat itself, which is pretty freaking epic if you ask me. And I hear so many noises, I am terrified. What about this nurse you back to health quest? I'm trying to get this quest done here. I just think I just gotta take down some nurses. Well, all right, nurses, get over here. Swing! Bada, 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 swing, swing! Oh, you survive! That's very cool. That wasn't very cash money of you nurses, but that's okay. We settled our differences quite epically, if you ask me. Now, what is it gonna take for us to actually finish this quest line, though? If I do recall over here. So we got the nurse you back to health. We just gotta find one more nurse for us to swing. Bada, 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 swing. Which we'll go ahead and get going. They should have spawned pretty much all around us. Let's just try and... Boop! Oh, dude. That is a whole new level of satisfactory. This baseball bat, it's a nice weapon. Boop! Wish it was higher leveled, but I will take it. And with that, we have completed the nurse's quest. And I'm not really interested in looting this place up besides knocking out that quest. I am on a little bit of a quest spree over here. And I do believe we have one a little bit to the north, actually. And this helicopter does make traveling long distances pretty easy. I just hope that I have the gas for it, because our gas is definitely running a bit on the low side. But up over there, we got something. Now, do we head over there first, or do I try and find some gas along the way? Because you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna scrap up this vehicle over here. We have access to a very, very good wrench over here, and wrenches are an extremely powerful tool. All right, that should be able to let's make sure that we got all proper goggles on, get us a little bit of gas from actually scrapping up some of these things. Iron shovel, nice. I will take that. But hopefully everyone's having an absolutely incredible day of the most amazing variety that only keeps on getting better from here on out, whether that be from the video bringing you a smile, bringing you a giggle, anything or everything like that. Does not matter to me how a little bit of joy can go ahead and make its way into your day today. I'm just crossing my fingers that needly do. That's exactly what the joy do do. Get it? Because do do, like indeed it does, but also like doo-doo, like, doo-doo. Alrighty, though, we do appear to be suffering from the complications of a heat stroke, so in addition to being hungry and thirsty in that lower left-hand corner, so definitely want to try and get out of this situation pretty quickly and get some food. We got quite a few things we really want to go ahead and do. We also need to get this awesome cripple mod over here, which I believe is a weapon mod we can toss on some weapons, so that'll be interesting for some of our weapons that do have a few more slots. Let's just go ahead and refuel that thing a little bit more. Nice, we're at 34%, and the thing about the gyrocopter, right, is that you gotta get some speed before you can take off. Like, it is, it's a bit difficult to actually take off from the roof. I learned that the hard way. I was literally trying to get off that roof that we ended the last episode off on, and it was quite a struggle. I had to drive off the bloody edge, and 0 out of 10 would not recommend. But what we are doing now is just levitating our jolly way over to this quest marker to the north, and dude, I love this. I'm not gonna lie, what I want to do is I just want to get all the gas we can and go on like a cross-country road trip helicopter style and try and find, obviously, some new towns, hopefully with some buildings we've never before seen, or more shotgun messiah factories. I'd definitely be a fan of that. But yeah, I would love to try and find some more like really cool buildings that we've yet to loot up, specifically like some skyscrapers and more complicated ones like that. And speaking of good news, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, word on the street is that Alpha 19 is actually going to be coming relatively soon, within the next few weeks. So I did want to make sure y'all are prepared for our Alpha 19 playthrough as soon as that does start. And whoo, mama, coming in a little bit high. Let's balance that out. Hello, just a nice little levitation here. Boop. Dude, I love this gyrocopter. The gyrocopter, I forgot, I delivered gyros from the sky. It's bloody epic, bro. So we got some sort of a quest over here that we can knock out slightly to the north. Shay. Hopefully I don't suffer from too much heat stroke. And this is a cable guys, never made it. All right, what about the cable guys? We got just a bunch of construction workers. No sprinters. Always gotta check for the sprinters. First and foremost, they are definitely the biggest threat to my life. Let's make sure that we have our experience goggles on so we get more experience from swinging up on these dudes. And then after we do get done knocking out a little bit of questing, we are going to make our way back home. I kind of want to make a freaking landing pad, or not even a landing pad, like an airport strip back at home, you know, because like you need like the gyrocopter is kind of like an airplane in a sense. Like you need a runway to take off. So I kind of want to, get a runway or something like that. But we just have a little bit of time. We might be able to go and turn these quests in and actually get another one. Oh no, we got another quest right over there in the middle of our town. Well. Hey, don't mind me, I will take the gyrocopter to go and do exactly that. And yeehaw, ride him cowboy. Let's get this thing going, dude. I've never wanted gas so much in my life. Not that kind of gas, you know what I mean. But I've never wanted gas so much in my life so I could just fuel this gyrocopter infinitely. And gyros. This gyrocopter runs off gyros and gas. The two G's that you need to succeed. That's right. When I get done playing some kind of competitive game, when I say GG, what I mean is gyros and gas. I don't mean good game, although I kind of also do. I mean gyro gas. Gas gyros. Stars gyrocopter delivering gas gyros. Bro, I'm just saying, we have some great business ideas stemming from this episode already. If anyone wants to invest into the gas gyrocopter delivered via, I don't know. We definitely got some marketing work to do. Don't get me wrong. Oh, mama, let's not go too much in a downward spiral here. I'm trying to stay low to the ground. Oh, no, let's not bounce too hard off there. Let's definitely not hit no trees. Okay. We got to get some air over here. This is not how I was expecting things to go. Come on, let's get a little bit of air. I'm very much so stuck to the ground at the moment. Please leave a message after the beep. Okay, there we go. We managed to get off the ground. You just gotta get enough speed to, like, have liftoff off the ground, sort of. It's like, it's weird to explain how it works, but it's interesting to say the least. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. We're actually gonna use this street right here as our landing pad. So we're gonna nosedive, and then, oh no! Ah! Okay! Stuck the landing! Don't know what you're talking about. I'm getting out of that thing before I die even more. From our perfect landing, that is. That's right. Our landing was so perfect, it caused me pain to know that no one else will ever be able to recreate such an epic and perfectly timed landing as what we just did over there. Bye! Goodbye to your face. No longer will you be needing that, compadre. Let's definitely go and scrap this thing up, because at this point, bro, I'm all aboard the scrapping car train, because, well, we get electrical parts, we get mechanical components, we get so many different parts on top of literal gas engines, like everything that the lad like me might need. So we'll go ahead and continue doing that. But yes, Alpha 19 is around the corner. I'm super excited for our Alpha 19 playthrough. And when that does come out, I am going to do my best. I want to do daily videos on 7 Days to Die Alpha 19 when that comes out. Ideally, the first day it comes out, bro, get like a double upload at the minimum or something like that. So I will be gunning to do that. Make sure you're subscribed and hit that notification bell to stay in the loop for that. It should be epic fun time, epic gamer moments all over the place. I hear so many things breaking. I'm terrified. Hello? I hear noises. Ah, there's a person over there. Nice, nice, nice. Well, I only have a crossbow with no ammo for guns, so we're going to melee route today, baby. Yay! Let's go and try to finish you off before anything gets too out of hand. Goodbye. To your face, to your face. Let's not have our lucky goggles on until we get to actually looting, such as we are right here. Gotta love the fact that the sledgehammer literally doubles down as, whatchamacallit? It kinda doubles down as, I can't think of the name. I'm having a brain derp. Having a brain derp! The torch! I knew that's exactly what I was trying to say all along. It doubles down as a torch. You love to see it, especially for some of these darker areas we do go into, in addition to our normal flashlight that we can. Oh, rock! Hello! Top of the morning! Guten Tag! Ho ho! I said top of the morning, not top of the ceiling. You don't have to jump up and hit that with your face. Oh, baby. She took that a little bit. She was really trying to get to the top of this morning, bro. She, Everyone's trying to get to the top of this morning. Hello. They're getting a little bit carried away. Okay, so that appears to be how we break into this mechanic shop. Someone just dug the most epic tunnel of epic proportions to make this happen. Let's get the lucky goggles back on. Let's get back to looting. But, nice stuff over there. We will be making our way back home. Ideally, dude, if we can, I would love, absolutely love, I thought maybe there might be something secret back there, to be able to construct our very first shotgun turret. That would be a dream come true, because ideally before Alpha 19 does end up hitting, because every time a new alpha does hit for 7 Days to Die, you do need to restart your world in order to get all the benefits that the update does bring, which is kind of obnoxious. But for a new alpha update, which only comes really like once a year at this point, like, it doesn't come off, and it's definitely gonna be an exciting time. So I'm super excited for that. Spread the word, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, that the new update is indeed around the corner. I have heard tentatively that they are aiming to have it out, I think, this upcoming weekend. Actually, they're gonna try to have a streamer weekend where before they make it publicly available, they give streamers a few days to mess around with it, to show off some details and kind of like also play test it in a sense before they do more widely release it. And hello to you, Missy. So it's tentatively, I do believe the word on the street is that that is going to be happening this weekend, but that is of course subject to delays. Things might come up. You never know with these type of development things. Yeet! Oh no, I missed your face. Oh, did not miss it that time. So yeah, just like a word of warning to y'all that it might not happen, but as of right now, they are indeed aiming for that to come out this upcoming weekend. And if that is the case, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, you are about to be getting so much more 7 Days to Die up your alley. Because I don't remember everything that this update is going to be bringing, but I did see some of the new weapons that they are going to be introducing, including, I think, a fully automatic shotgun, a new sniper rifle. Like, so many awesome things that literally just have me falling in love. I think, like, new locations, like, so much stuff like that. And obviously, I'll have, like, more full patch notes for y'all as that time does approach. Oh, I hear noises. Hello, he's got a runner. How did I miss? How did I miss? Dude, you what, dude? You what, mate? You what, mate? Net, 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 net. All right, there we go. I got to regenerate and bop. There we go. Dude, that's the one problem. We don't have an emergency gun to help us out if things hit the fan. We're kind of freeballing a little bit in a sense, right? And we just got to clear out this entire location. And this location might be a bit trickier than I expected. Love to see that. Yes! Love to see him going flying. Hello, bird and lady. Let's just go ahead and come on. Boop. Goodbye to you. Yellow sedan over here. Come on, give me some of the goods. Nice. As much as it is starting to get kind of late in game time, so I might not spend all the time in the world looting every single thing. I'll still loot a lot of it, don't get me wrong, but we do have to kind of start prioritizing because nighttime is almost here, dude. And we go to get this thing finished up. Because when nighttime hits, well, I'm not in the most comfortable position. I don't have a gun with me at the moment. So yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and scrap a few of these things to consolidate on a little bit of that room. I'll get rid of that two over there just because it is not, like, it's only two and that thing stacks up to like 1,000. So we could definitely get something more useful in exchange for that. Let's definitely, we got our nice lucky goggles on. Hopefully find something good. Yeah, I love to see the glue, baby. Hey, I got a few more things over here. A band-aid, which I am kind of in need of. I need my maximum health over there to regenerate. I get this question sometimes. Star, why does your health not always regenerate to 139? Because our maximum health is 139. But this little grayed area that isn't filled in with red is kind of like our maximum health. So right now, there's like still like a little bit of dark gray left. I think our maximum health is around like 137, 138 right now. But eating, using like certain healing items will actually improve your maximum health. So then your actual health can go up. So 139 is kind of like the max for your max health. It's Maxception, pretty much. And if your name's Max, I'm sorry, it's not Maxception in the name of the person. It's like the maximum, the inception of maximum. Yes, that's exactly what it is. Now I can't quite figure out how in tarnation I'm supposed to get to this next area. It's gotta be, oh, right here, a little window to the wall. Wow, we got about 1 hour until things get extra bad. Our stamina is getting pretty bad, speaking of which. So I just gotta try and back it up over here, get our stamina back, because low key. Oh no, 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 no. Okay, we gotta shank. It's time to get to shanking. Oh no. Oh, parkour. Ow. Okay, we're locking him in there. I need some stamina. Give me the Mega Crush! I need all the stamina in the world, baby! Our maximum stamina is a little bit low because I haven't been eating a lot of food, just because I kind of have been neglecting the whole food part. Kind of an important thing to neglect. Definitely might be on that. Okay. Come on. Plenty of sledgehammer for everybody! Come on. Shabona! Goodbye to you. Oh, baby. That freaking energy drink just saved us pretty darn well. But yes, super excited for Alpha 19, and hopefully y'all are as well. And ideally, there's going to be a lot more 7 Days to Die going up when that does come out. And hello, that is nice wrench you have there. I will take the feathers. I'll say goodbye. I'll say goodbye to corn. Oh my god, that thing went flying in the back of our screen. Holy guacamole. Let's see if there's maybe like any kind of foods or waters or stuff like that that we might be able to sip up on. Only some of these are lootable for some reason. I don't get why, but whatever you say, buddy. You are the beverage cooler. I am just the man trying to loot the beverage cooler. We are on completely different wavelengths, you know, bro? Okay, glad we can agree. Hello. Ooh, nice. That's a sealed shipping crate. Might have something good in there. Nothing that great. I can just scrap that. Level 1 tools I just tend to scrap and smelt down. They're not as valuable. I will drink up on the yucca. Goodbye to that. Goodbye to empty water bottle. Goodbye to the cloth. Those are some things I'm definitely not in desperate need of. We got a... nothing over there. Are there like any cabinets that I could loot up? Anything that might have some food? Because your boy's going surprisingly hungry. There might be food in my helicopter, but y'all don't understand. Sometimes I'm just stubborn. I don't feel like walking out and walking back in. So in about 15 minutes, things are about to get extra bad. So I'm just going to rely on our stamina regen. Hopefully regenning extra hard. Oh, mama! And they're flying in. Holy guacamole. Boop! There we go. We got to take this man out before something bad goes down. Because he's a sprinter. And as long as no one else is a sprinter, I reckon, we'll be pretty okay. Pretty okay. Not 100% okay, but mostly okay. And over here, speaking of which, bro, we got the break room. If there's not food in this place, I don't... Okay, dude, there's gotta be food. There's a food stockpile. Goldenrod tea. That's not the food I was looking for. That is not what I was looking for. Let's have another one of these for hopefully a lot of stamina regen, because nighttime is pretty much here, which means things are going to get thuggly. Now, all zombies will be sprinting at us. How impossible is it to find food? Dog food! I'll take it, because I'm a dog. Awful pun. I'm sorry. I know. Listen, happy Father's Day, all right? There's your dad joke for the day. Hopefully, by the way, everyone is having a great Father's Day out there. Hopefully, y'all are spending some quality time with the fam and all that. And to all the fathers out there, did want to wish y'all specifically a happy Father's Day. But yeah, hopefully, y'all are having a good one there. And okay, I am hearing a lot of zombie noises now. My levels of terrifying have gone significantly up. I am a little bit scared. A lot of it scared, actually. I'm quite terrified. I am intrigued. Hello! I don't know what that was. There might be something up here. Yeah, there's something up there. Okay. Say no more, fam. I'm in. It'll give us a quick little safe haven from some zombies, too. Hello. That looks super secret-y. Ah! Ah! Yeah, let's make sure that we don't fall through the roof. Even though we're just gonna fall back down to exactly where we were. I prefer not falling through the roof, you know? It's just a personal preference. I like not having to fall through the floor on which I'm standing. Now, this over here is intriguing. Could this be hiding something? It can be. Hello! Nope, we're good. We are great. Okay, hello. We are great. That, ladies and gentlemen, is a hidden stash where we have... Oh, mama, we found some ammo. We found a nice iron helmet, some tin cans that I'm going to scrap. Oh, baby, things are coming along nicely. Let's drink up on that golden rod. Let's grab that Molotov cocktail, bro. That'll make for some fun base defense. Trust me, Molotov cocktail's always fun for the whole family. Now. Where does this lead to? This is an interesting little hole. I want to explore. Hello? We gotta crouch through, it appears. And there is a ladder. The ladder goes over there. And also a ladder that goes up. We will continue exploring that hole later. For now, I'd like to continue exploring the interior of this location. Okay, there's not a lot more interior to really go. I gotta admit here, there's not a lot of interior. Hello, what you hiding? Oh, baby! Exactly what we came here looking for, the courier's stash. Oh, baby. Gotta love that. Oh, speaking of all these seeds that I'm dropping, I'm not gonna lie, I haven't started a farm or like a whole like farming system in 7 days to die in a while. It's definitely something, if we don't get to do it around Alpha 18, I definitely want to restart Alpha 19 series, since it's ideally going to be a lot more common. Whatchamacall is something that, hello, we hopefully will be able to integrate into our, can't think of the name, base. I knew that word all along. Don't know what you're talking about. Oh, first the dog food, now the cat food. Ladies and gentlemen, we are feasting like kings. This is all gonna fall apart, dude. Yeah, that looked very sketchy. I had a feeling about that. Okay, well, now that that's all over and I'm only slightly brown my pants, we're back in business. And why do I feel like business is going to involve zombies flying towards me at Mach 5 speeds? And I see a burb. Oh, no, not the burb. Not the burb. Well, I don't really have anything that I can shoot these projectiles out of. And my nail gun isn't loaded either, so it does appear like we are gonna have to handle things the old-fashioned way. All right, I'm gonna bring out the bat, actually. I'm gonna repair this bat, make sure that it's just ready to go, bro. This bat's gotta be ready to go, because zombies are about to be flying towards us. Hello, birdie. Ah! Big hit, baby. You know what, we're gonna turn this thing on. We're getting all sneaky-deaky-like now. Bam, 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 bam. Bam, bam, bam-a-nil! 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 Bam, bam-a-nil, bam, bam, bam. Okay, I know for a fact that someone is gonna be in here. I like the baseball bat just because we can swing it a lot faster usually. And look at that, dude. Look at that knockdown. That's exactly what we're looking for. If you can just knock down a zombie that's sprinting at you, it buys you some essential time. That's exactly what I'm hunting for right now. That and zombies. Okay, nothing in that one over there. So this little subsection appears to be clear. We still got the roof to get up to over there. There's gonna be a few zombies here. You already know, bro. You already know. And that there is any tough ones. So we got a biker zombie. Yowzers. I don't like the way this is going. Can I maybe just get one of them to attack me? Hello. Can one of you guys come and attack me? Not all of you, just one of you. Beautiful, beautiful. I just want to take down one at a time. Marvelous, marvelous, marvelous. We are big brain here, baby. Yeet! And sayonara. Anyone else? City takers, please. Just one. Not, don't come one, come all. Just come one. Come one, okay? This ain't the circus, all right? Not come one, come all. Just one of y'all. Show up. Come on. Okay, there we go. And we got this dude showing up this time around. This is a big boy. I reckon we're gonna need the big guns. Bop! Yeah, we had to set him on fire with a sledgehammer. Overkill, That's my middle name, baby. And not like Halo. This ain't a freaking quad kill in a short amount of time that we're talking. All right, I am overkill. Bop. Oh, I thought we could like hit him across the edge. That would have been hilarious. Okay, let's get that stamina back so I can blow your brains out, brother. All right. Medical supplies. I could use some of these, maybe. I don't need a splint. The roids are nice, though. I suppose I will. Yeah, just drop some of the water. That's just some normal water. Ain't nothing too special. Nothing up there, so now upwards we go. Bird's nest, I don't really care too much about that. This is kind of like the secret area we found a shortcut to. So it looks like that's just a bit of a shortcut you can take. Yeah, dude, there's... Oh, not the dogs. Not the doggos, not the doggos! I hate these things! I love dogs, IRL! I despise zombie dogs, they are terrifying! Absolutely terrifying. Yeet! How did I miss you? How did I actually miss you? Excuse me, lady. That's not allowed. That is cheating. Stop cheating. Ow, that hurts. Ow. Ow, stop it. Stop it, Missy. Stop it. You're causing me a lot of pain. I cannot run efficiently enough. This is not good. This is not good. This is not good. Okay, okay, okay. Don't mind me. Just kind of... Oh, she's chasing after me. She's chasing after us. Yeet! Bless up. That saved us. Okay, I'm taking one of these first aid kits. Please leave a message after the beep. Beep. Nice. I'm not gonna lie, she threw me off a bit because I definitely should have whammed her upside the head, but that did not go as planned now, did it? No, it did not. Food pile over here. Beautiful. We got a little bit of canned dog food. I will chow down on some of the honey, bro. I will take anything and everything that I can. Besides that, though, I'll leave... There's just a few wooden planks. I'll probably leave those behind. Grab the golden rod. That's pretty nice. We got the right goggles on. Let's get to opening up all of these things. Yo, nice motor tool, bro. I know where that's going. If you don't mind me, I'll just modify that. And boop, we can toss that on there. Save an inventory slot. But, still have everything that we need. Bop number one. Bop number two. And then bop number three. Everything is opened up. Yo, let's go. Level 6 leather boots. Y'all don't even know. Full level armor is one of the best things you can get. We can literally, if we play our cards right, sell this for thousands of dollars. That is naughty. Absolutely crazy. I love it. I'm a big fan of it. 10 out of 10 would open this chest again. Now, besides that, Shay, I suppose. Can I grab that and modify this with it? I can. Beautiful. That'll save an extra inventory slot there while still making sure we can grab everything we want. We have already learned these books, so they are not going to be as useful to us. Mini bike handlebars are nice. We just learned how to make a gas can, apparently. All right. We big brain here. I might just scrap the mini bike handlebars and get a little bit of iron from that because we already have our mini bike built. Yeah, we built that one a while ago. Advanced bellows, I think we already have that, but it's nonetheless a pretty nice thing to grab. Okay, we got a little bit of inventory managing here to do. Oh, I didn't realize this. Check it out, dudes. If you scrap an engine, you get 30, is that motorized parts? Bro, that's actually crazy. That's one of the resources we've been running a little bit low on. No longer. We big brain here now, folks. Oh, baby, that is actually quite the nice development, if you ask me. Then we can grab everything else that we need from here. We have cleared the area. We have collected the thing for the trader, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. This little gas station is no longer a threat. Let's also go ahead and bloop. We'll pop these things on the lickety split so we have 10 minutes of full carry capacity because our strength is otherwise not high enough to actually carry everything without being over encumbered, which does affect our stamina, our sprint speed, all that jazz. So we have fixed that and now everything is good in the hood. There we go. Let's make sure we don't die from that. And we got to get out of here. Get on up out of here. Well, all right. Let me get on up out of here in just one moment. But yeah, dudes, I am so excited for Alpha 19 around the corner, man. It is always rough having to start a new world for those new updates, but bro, gotta admit, man, it is going to be quite freaking epic. And we're definitely gonna try and have a huge send-off in this series 2, y'all. Boop! We're definitely gonna try and have a big send-off in our 7 days to die save here. I do want to have a huge shebang where we upgrade our base to the max and go up against one final horde at the very least. And ideally, have some more fun with the gyrocopter. Because, bro, come on, man. Like, look at this thing. What is there not to love? What is there not to love, eh? Okay, let's go ahead and get a little bit of that air that I was talking about. And looky, looky here. We are airborne yet again. This doesn't really have the best headlights, I must admit, but we're still airborne. Haters are my motivators. And there we have home, sweet home. Let's just make sure to kind of stick the landing. Okay, I don't know if I'd call that sticking the landing, but I will take it. Yeah, I have not figured out exactly the best way to land this thing, I gotta admit. Oh, baby. Yeah, how are we still? Okay, there we go. We hit the brakes, hit the brakes, hit the brakes, hit the brakes. Okay, and I'm just gonna pop out. There we go. All right. And there's a gyrocopter. The street will be my landing strip. I think that is for the best. Yo, and check this out, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Last episode, before we left home, we did actually do a little experiment here. So in case y'all don't know, this is kind of like the levels of our wall. We've been upgrading our wall quite a little bit. So we started at this level using rocks and stuff. Then we upgraded to concrete. And then we upgraded the concrete with more concrete to this, which actually does not appear to be the most powerful thing in the world, and it can no longer be upgraded. So unless I'm missing something, it doesn't have as much health. Like, look at this. We do, like, plenty of damage to this. I wonder if it's, I actually wonder if this is still drying, because a lot of these things do actually, like, a lot of these, like, when you upgrade concrete, right, it does actually have to set in and dry. So I wonder if this isn't even the final stage and it is still drying. I hope that that's the case. And ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we've done a little bit of inventory managing and whatnot, and we're gonna get some big things going. We got another blade trap we gotta set up as our base defenses, obviously. That's all cool, but the shotgun auto turret, that is also something we are going to set up. But first, we actually need to craft a motion sensor, which luckily we have everything we need to create. This motion sensor is pretty much going to be the basis on which our shotgun auto turret is created. Otherwise, we do gotta grab some steel. Hopefully, I have enough in my my storage chest for that. Otherwise, I'm gonna be big sad. Good news! We got it! That brings us to 48, and I believe we should be at the 46 or so. So let's just go ahead and grab that motion sensor, which adds a new journal entry. Can we actually, like, I wonder, is this something we can just put down? Oh, that's something we can just put down, like, normally. I was not, oh, interesting. I kind of want to mess around with that a little bit. So yeah, we can actually use this to kind of, like, I think you can use the motion sensor and hook up a trap to it, and it will actually, like, activate a trap when it senses motion. So that'd be kind of interesting to mess around with. But for the most important thing right now that I do want to set up with this motion sensor is the shotgun auto turret. We just need a little bit of oil, some shotgun parts, and some scrap polymers. So let's just go ahead and scrap polymers. We got some oil, I believe, from today's adventure. Beautiful, right on the dot there. And we still need 3 shotgun parts. I have 3 shotgun parts, right? I have that. Yes, no, maybe. Beauty 17, bro. We got plenty. And now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, say hello to the shotgun auto turret in about like 7 minutes. And there we have it, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. We are now the proud owner of a brand spanking new shotgun auto turret. And there are some obnoxious zombies upstairs just waiting to get blasted with this thing. So let's set it up and hopefully see it in action for the very first time. This is exciting. And yo, hello. There we have the upgraded stuff. So it looks like it literally was just waiting for that to finish. Let's just definitely go and we'll set this thing up. I reckon, where would I like this? Yeah, let's have it set up right about over there. And we'll go ahead. I won't even have the switch going to this one. I'll just go directly from the battery bank to none other than our turret right over there. So now what should happen is if we do go ahead and turn, actually I won't even turn that on, let's turn on the battery bank, like this thing is already plenty powered, we should now have a shotgun turret awaiting orders. Let's just make sure that, oh my god, talk about a weird angle. We just toss some ammo into there, lock it, and check it out. We can even look at this camera preview. We can manually aim the turret. So if we could just get shotgun, come on, get over a little bit closer. No, so close, man. All right, I'll leave this thing on auto. Come on, come all zombies, please let my turret. Oh my god, do some work, baby. Oh, me and the shotgun turrets are gonna be BFFs forever. That, yeah, it's confirmed. It's confirmed. BFFs forever. And we got another one of these we could hook up, which we'll go ahead and get set up. But oh, mama, I am in love. The shotgun auto turret, a thing to be reckoned with. And again, remember, there are like SMG auto turrets too. We just gotta continue leveling up, which is why I am looking forward to some adventures, hopefully some flying around, that type of stuff. Let's kind of continue. Like, I don't know if you can like manually like aim it. I don't know if it like aims every direction or if it only aims the direction you're looking at. I'm not 100% sure on those, but regardless, let's just go and bip. Turn that thing off. That's enough out of you, Mr. Battery Bank. And now, let's get this switch. This is the switch of death over here. To hook up to that mother trucker right over there. And I actually believe, if I'm not mistaken, this one has, we gotta go and hook up, we gotta hook up a few things actually, now that I'm looking at things. This electrical system is getting too complex for me, I tell you. Boop, we gotta hook it up to that. There's not like a limit on how many wires I can have running, right? Like, I'm not gonna lie, living inside of my base is slowly turning into a large electrical hazard, but we're not gonna talk about that, we're just gonna talk about all the blades! So yeah, I do need to run a little bit of a relay from here over to this one. Beautiful, beautiful. And that one is powering that guy. This guy appears to be powered, so I think all of our blades work. Let's just go and give this thing a quick little test over here. So whenever we turn on the battery bank, turrets automatically turn on. We could route the turrets over to a completely different switch if we wanted to have one be like the blade switch, maybe like have the switch like each turn on a certain wall. There's so much cool stuff you can do with the 7 Days to Die electrical system. But the maximum power output on this is 215 watts. So this will be interesting because we are literally outputting the max. Yeah, is every blade trap powered? How's that working? Actually, yes. Literally every blade trap is powered right now. Let's go. Because technically speaking, we have like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, which is 180 power plus that turret. So technically speaking, until we find some more batteries, the power that our battery bank generates is capped. It cannot power any more of those blade traps or turrets. But our over here, our engine thing can produce 300 watts. So if we go to fuel power, we'll be okay. But we gotta try and find some better batteries to jam into the battery bank to probably upgrade these level 1 batteries to improve the output that that is capable of. But holy guacamole, y'all. This is loco, and I'm in love. And oh, we got a wandering horde. They're gonna wander right past us, though. So no worries there, so yeah, things are getting kind of crazy, and when we return, they will continue getting crazier. We gotta continue upgrading our base to hopefully using more cement and stuff like that. Getting some more turrets, improving our electrical output. We officially have like 2 entire walls pretty much bladed up, which is crazy. Like, look at all these blades. Look at all those blades. We got 1 turret finally manned. We got a gyrocopter ready to freaking fly and deliver some gyros. And I mean, we still got quite the large portion of the map that is unexplored. So when we return, we're going to turn in our quests. We're going to get a new one. And maybe we'll get one in an uncharted territory. Maybe I'll just get one a few kilometers away and just fly over and see what we can find. Because we've gone to the east. We've gone a bit to the south. We haven't gone to the north, because there's a giant ocean there that we now are going to be able to fly over as long as we have the gas for it. Like, lots of, and we just could get a lot of gas, by the way. So things are definitely getting interesting. But with that said, with that done, that's going to go to start bringing an end to this episode of 7 Days to Die. Thank you guys for holding, for watching. Hi, this was an awesome one, and I'll talk to you in the next one. See ya.